Welcome to an example on how to subtract fractions with unlike denominators. The main thing to remember is that when we add or subtract fractions, we must have a common denominator. We need a common denominator so that we add or subtract parts or pieces of the same size. Once we have a common denominator to subtract two fractions, the denominator stays the same, and we subtract the numerators. Looking at our example, we have 5/6 minus 1/2. So the first thing to recognize here is that we do not have a common denominator, and therefore we cannot subtract the fractions in this form. If we're able to determine the smallest possible common denominator, it's called the least common denominator, which is the least common multiple of 6 and 2, which is also the smallest number divisible by both 6 and 2. We don't have to use the least common denominator in order to subtract the fractions. We can use any common denominator. But because 6 is the least common multiple of 6 and 2, which is also the smallest number divisible by 6 and 2, if we want to subtract these fractions using the least common denominator, both fractions need a denominator of 6. So let's first find this difference using the least common denominator of 6. The first fraction already has a denominator of 6, so we have 5/6. And then to write an equivalent fraction to 1/2, with a denominator of 6, we would multiply the numerator and denominator by 3, because 2 times 3 is equal to 6. So we'd have 5/6 minus 3/6. And now that we have a common denominator, we can find this difference. The denominator stays 6, and now we subtract the numerators. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. So this is the difference, but because 2 and 6 share a common factor of 2, this does simplify. There are a couple ways of showing the simplification. One way is to divide the numerator and denominator by 2. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1, and 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. So the difference equals 1/3. Now let's look at the model below. If we define the rectangle as one whole, here's the model for 5/6, and here's the model for 1/2. We want to remove this amount from this amount. But before we do this, we need the pieces to be the same size. So looking at the model for 1/2, if we cut or partition the rectangle into 6 equal parts or pieces like this, this shows 1/2 is equivalent to 3/6. So now we have 5/6 minus 3/6. And if we remove this amount from this amount, or these 3 pieces from these 5 pieces, we're left with a total of 2 pieces, where each piece is 1/6. So the difference is 2/6, which looks like this. Again, if we remove these 3 pieces from these 5 pieces, we're left with these 2 pieces. But we can express this fraction using larger pieces. The rectangle is one whole, and if we cut it into 3 equal parts or pieces, here and here, we can see that 2/6 is equivalent to 1/3. Now, I do want to show this one more way by determining a common denominator that is not the least common denominator. One way we can always find a common denominator is to find the product of the two denominators. Here, notice 6 times 2 is equal to 12, so we could write both of these fractions with denominators of 12 and then perform the subtraction. So let's also show that. So beginning with, again, 5/6 minus 1/2. If we use the common denominator of 12, we'd multiply the first fraction by 2 over 2, and the second fraction by 6 over 6. Notice now the equivalent fractions are 10/12, and then minus 6/12. Subtracting, the denominator stays the same, and 10 minus 6 equals 4, so the difference is 4/12. Which does simplify. There's a common factor of 4 between 4 and 12. And notice how we do get the same result. 4 divided by 4 is 1, and 12 divided by 4 is equal to 3. So we can always find a common denominator by determining the product of the two denominators. In most cases, it won't be the least common denominator, but it'll still give you a common denominator. It just requires extra simplifying after subtracting. I hope you found this helpful.